In this video, I'll be giving you 10 tips that every graffiti writer or artist should know. More about this after the intro. What's up? My name is Chuck. If this is your first time here and you're into graffiti, or you're just planning on doing your first graffiti piece soon, then you should definitely click the subscribe button so that you won't miss any of our videos. In this video, I'll be giving you 10 basic graffiti tips that every graffiti writer or artist should know. Some of these tips I already knew when I just started out, and some of these I found out way too late. So this video is more for the people who are just starting to do graffiti. But if you're longer in the game than yesterday, I hope there's still one or two useful tips for you in this video. After you've been watching this video, I really like to know what kind of tips and tricks videos I should make in the future, so that I can hopefully help you out with your questions. Let's jump into it. Tip number one, loosen up the mixing bowl. The most of you have had this problem before. A can with a mixing bowl that wouldn't get loose. This can happen when your can has been really cold, like in the winter, or when the can has been laying around for a long time. The pigment in the paint will settle down, and this causes the mixing bowl to get stuck in the paint. If this is the case, you have to shake the can really well in order to make sure that the can works. This is how you can make sure the bowl comes loose. Instead of shaking the can only like this, shake it also like this. If that won't help, you can also try to do this. But this can hurt a little bit. If that doesn't work, you can also try to hit the can against the bottom of your shoe, like this. Tip number two. Put a fat cap on new cans. Even though you shake the can really well, the paint that's already inside the tube of the can stays really thick. By putting a skinny cap or an outline cap on a new can cause the caps to clog, which makes the caps unusable and you have to take a new one. By simply putting a fat cap on the can first, you make sure the thick paint is out of the can. This is to make sure the can will work properly. Tip number three, clean your used caps. This tip doesn't always work, but a lot of time it does. After you've been painting, you can turn the can upside down and spray. This way, you make sure that the last bit of paint is no longer in the cap. If you don't do this, the paint will stay in the cap and will dry in. After it has been dried in, you can no longer use the cap. Tip number four. How can you see the difference between a skinny and a fat cap? If you're not sure what kind of caps you got with you and you're looking for a skinny or a fat cap, then there is one simple way to find out. By looking to the inside of the cap, you can find out what kind of cap you're holding. The bigger the gap the mill cap has, the more paint can get out of the can through the cap. This is also how they used to make fat caps back in the days, by making the gap bigger for a higher output. As you can see, this gap is really small. This is a German outline cap. This cap has a really big gap, as you can tell. This is a Montana Level 6 cap. Tip number five. Use a magnet to silence your can. Some graffiti brands sell strong magnets to make sure that this mixing bowl stays in place. This way, you're making less noise while painting. But in fact, you can use every magnet that's strong enough. Unfortunately, you can't do this with every can. Some brands use glass or plastic mixing bowls. There are also some markers with steel mixing bowls. This means you can put a magnet on these markers as well. Just make sure you don't put that marker next to your phone. If you like this video so far, you should check out this one, where I'll be giving you some tips how to become a faster graffiti writer. Tip number six, wear gloves. If you're doing graffiti on a regular basis, you can get tired of cleaning your hands all the time. Getting the paint off your skin is pretty easy. But the nails, and I guess if you're a boy, you don't want your nails to look like you have polished them, right? So make sure you wear gloves so you don't get any paint on your fingers. And while filming this video, it's below 0 degrees. So wearing some gloves is a must if you don't want your hands to freeze off. Tip number 7, wear your clothes inside out. You came up with a nice color scheme, brought all the paint you needed, and you're on the spot. But you forgot to bring your old jacket and you're wearing your new one. Well, there's one simple solution for that. Take your jacket off and turn it inside out. If you get any drips or overspray on the inside of your jacket, no one will ever see it when you turn the inside back in. And you won't catch a cold as well. Maybe I should have come up with this idea a little bit earlier. Tip number 8. Get the last bit of paint out of the can. You only have to fill the last part of your piece, but you ran out of paint. And you were so confident that you brought enough. Trust me, I've been there. This doesn't always work, but when it does, you will thank me. By kicking on the top of the can, you're pushing the tube that's inside the can right to the bottom of it. This will make sure you're getting the last bit of paint out of the can. And then you can finally finish your piece. Tip number 9. Turn a high pressure can into a low pressure can. High pressure cans are really nice if you want to get the job done quickly, but they are a pain in the ass if you want to make details with them. If you turn the can upside down and you press the cap, you will release the gas out of the can. The gas that's inside the can makes sure that the paint gets out of the can once you press the cap. By releasing the gas out of the can, you make sure there is less pressure inside the can. This results in a lower output. This way, you can make perfect details without any drips. Okay, it's enough. Tip number 10. Never leave your empty cans behind. After you've been painting, always make sure you take the empty cans with you. By leaving your cans behind, whether this is in a hall of fame or in the streets, people can find these and start scribbling around without knowing the rules of graffiti. Some people spend hours on one piece, which can be ruined in a matter of seconds. If you really don't want to take the cans with you, make a hole in them. This way, there's no longer any gas in the can and people can't use the can anymore. The bottom of the can is a really weak place. By using the handle of your roller, you can easily make a hole in the bottom of your can, like this. In this video, I'll be giving you tips how you can become a faster graffiti writer. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I hope to see you soon.